வணக்கம், கிரீட்டிங்ஸ் டு ஆல் இந்தியன் ஃபாரஸ்ட் சர்வீஸ் ஆஸ்பிரண்ட்ஸ். ஒன்ஸ் அகெய்ன் எ வார்ம் அண்ட் ஹார்ட்டி வெல்கம் டு ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ டு மை யூடியூப் சேனல் சில்வா, எ லேடர் டு ரீச் கேனபி. லாஸ்ட் செஷன் வி சாய் அபவுட் அக்ரோ ஃபாரஸ்ட்ரி, சோஷியல் ஃபாரஸ்ட்ரி அண்ட் ஜாயிண்ட் ஃபாரஸ்ட் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி த சிலபஸ் ஆஃப் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அண்ட் அப்ளைடு சப்ஜெக்ட், தட் இஸ் த ஃபாரஸ்ட் சாயில்ஸ், சாயில் கன்சர்வேஷன் அண்ட் watershed management. These three important aspects are going to be part of this subject: forest soils, soil conservation and watershed management. As you all aware that soil is a important factor in any plant formation because it is the bedrock for plant formation. Being in agriculture, horticulture or forestry, studying of soil is very important in different aspects. So understanding the soil, its characteristic will help a lot in major intervention, especially in the applied aspects. In forestry, studying of forest soil is crucial, starting from the nursery to the intervention stage, that is the afforestation. In afforestation, generally the forestry sector encountered with various kind of problem, that is the problematic soil. The problem may be due to the physical like erosion or due to the chemical. The chemical may be the due to the presence of excess salt or any other contents. So for understanding these issues, studying of forest soil is very crucial. Let us see one by one from the forest soil, soil conservation and watershed management. Under forest soil, we will start with the classification of forest soil. Classifying or classification is important for the better management. In forestry, the soil is mainly classified based on the organic matter content. Based on that, the forest soil is classified into two broader classification, that is the organic soil and the mineral soil. And another important classification that is based on the United States Department of Agriculture. So differentiating the soil into the different types will help in understanding the soil, its problems, and also helps in the intervention. So all these things will be studied in detail in the future session, followed by the factors affecting soil formation. The soil formation process is not that simple because it's a very, very complex phenomenon. So there are four important aspects or the factors which are reasonable for soil formation, starting from the parent rock, that is from which the soil is originating, followed by the climatic factors, rainfall, temperature, relative humidity, so many other factors which are also equally important in influencing the soil formation, followed by the topography, especially the depth aspect. They are also very important, especially in determining the soil depth. And finally, with the humus or the organic matter content. So all these four factors will be dealt in detail in the future session, followed by physical, chemical and biological properties. So studying of physical, chemical and biological properties also helps a lot in various applied aspects. In physical aspect, we will be studying about the particle density, bulk density and texture, structure, followed by the chemical property, that is about the cation exchange capacity, anion exchange capacity and electrical conductivity. In biological property, we will be focusing only about the humus, that is the addition of organic content and which will become a humus, and how they are very important in the changing vegetation or the formation of different kind of vegetation in a given area, followed by the soil conservation. Studying the forest soil is very crucial in the applied aspect, that is the soil conservation point of view. So we will be studying about the soil conservation and in detail about the causes for erosion. The erosion is one of the major challenges in the forest soil or any soil, and in India nearly 175 million hectare is already affected due to the different kind of problem soils. So we will be studying about the erosion what is erosion and what are the different types of erosion and causes of erosion. And in India, generally we encounter the two types of erosion. One is about the wind erosion and water erosion. Wind erosion generally one can see in the coastal and desert area, and water erosion any degraded or denuded land one can find. So all these things will be detailedly dealt in the coming classes. Conservation and management of eroded soils and eroded areas, and how the different interventions through the biological, agronomical or the engineering aspects will be helped in conserving and managing the different type of eroded soil. And in this subject we will be also studying about the windbreaks and shelter belt. These are the two significant biological intervention that especially followed to protect or to safeguard the different kind of habitation or the agriculture or any kind of lands nearby. So how to design the windbreaks and how to design the shelter belt, and what are the dimension to be adapted, and what are the vegetation to be selected, all these things will be dealt here. Windbreaks, what is windbreak and what is shelter belt, how these two things can be differentiated. And sand dunes, another significant feature in the desert area, and this is nothing but the movement of sand from one place to another place, and it having a different shape and sizes, and how to deal the sand dunes, especially how to arrest the sand dunes by adapting agronomical, biological and engineering aspects will be studied here. Reclamation of saline and alkaline soil, this is the most problem from the chemical point of view due to the addition or the due to the excess soil salt content or particular chemical available in the soil, which creates a lot of problem in penetration of water inside the into the ground, affect the vegetation formation, and how to deal with, especially due to the excess of sodium, excess of calcium content in the soil, or it affect the vegetation formation, and how to deal with, especially due to the excess of sodium, excess of calcium content in the soil part. And waterlogged and other wastelands, and waterlogging is also very important problem in many areas where there is a huge rainfall, especially in the Western Ghats and all. That also poses a different kind of challenging, affecting the vegetation formation, or not able to allow any kind of vegetation in that particular area. These things also will be dealt in this soil conservation. And we will be also studying about the role of forest in conserving soil. So due to the presence of various kind of vegetation, especially the trees, shrubs, herbs and grasses in the forest area, how the different strata present in the forest area can help in conserving the soil. So the role will be very typically studied in this soil conservation aspect. And maintenance and build up of soil organic matter, that I mentioned that this is the most important biological property of the forest soil, and how this organic matter is slowly added to the soil or the area, and how nutrient changes taking place in that particular area, that will be also covered here. And provision of loppings for the green leaf manuring, and green leaf manuring is one of the important interventions especially practiced in the agriculture area, artificially by collecting the green leaves of different leguminous species, and how it can alter the soil characteristic, especially the new nutrient status and all, will be studied here. And the best trees with leaves which can be added for this purpose also will be noted here. And forest leaf litter and composting, so that is also studied, and how the leaf litter alters the soil characteristic. And also will be studying about the different types of forest area and their nutrient contents, and how the leaf litter composition and their accordingly the nutrient content variation all will be studied here. And role of microorganism in ameliorating the soil. The microorganism is another important applied part in the forest soil, because they are very helpful in improving the soil, not only in the nursery area but also in the plantation forestry also. A lot of biofertilizers are available nowadays, like VAM, Acetobacter, all these things. So these examples and how they are available and how they are practically applied in the nursery or any afforestation program will be studied here, followed by the nitrogen and carbon cycle, and they are very crucial in the life form in the globe, and nitrogen cycle and the carbon cycle. So all these two cycles will be dealt, and how the exchange taking place, and from one level to another level, and finally with the VAM, vesicular orbicular mycorrhiza, the another important microorganism, and mainly useful in nursery and plantation forestry, and the different there are three types of VAM available. So all will be studied here, and after the forest soil and soil consideration, the finally with the watershed management. So as you all aware that watershed, the area where it drains to a common point, the forest is very important from the watershed point of view, because the coincidentally most of the watershed are available in the forest area only. So they are acting as a important catchment, collecting the water and draining to the common area. So we'll be studying about the concept of watershed, what is about the gully, first order, second order and third order watershed, all will be studied here, and the role of mini forest and forest trees in overall resource management, how the areas covered with the vegetation can be helping in the collecting the water and draining the water, and how slowly the water level or the hydrological level of that area can be improved. So we will be studying about the water hydrology also in detail, about from one level to another level. Watershed development in respect of torrent control, river channel stabilization, avalanche and landslide control. So these are the different areas like avalanche in case of Himalaya, and torrent control or river channel stabilization is part of any river vegetation or the river ecosystem. And where how the watershed development can be helpful in treating these problematic situation like landslide, avalanche, torrent control, river channel stabilization, and rehabilitation of degraded area, hilly and mountain area, because again this is a very important problem, especially from the physical point of view, and how the degraded areas are treated by using or adapting the different watershed approach, and that is the biggest problem in the hilly or the mountain area, and how the intervention made by adapting different watershed approaches. And finally with the watershed management and environmental functions of forest, so that will be also covered here. Water harvesting and conservation, and what forest is a important source of water conservation. So there are different type of interventions like the engineering structure, biological structure, intervention of these or creation of these structures are helping in improving the water condition in that particular area. The engineering structure may be due construction of aniquets or the check dams, and different kind of ponds, different kind of dams, earthen embankment. So all are the typical example of water harvesting, and how these are planned in the forest area, and how the gully is treated, how the different areas in watershed are treated, and what are the criteria of adapting the different kind of intervention in different type of area, all will be studied in detail along with the clear-cut pictures also, and the groundwater recharge and watershed management, and once the intervention is made in the watershed, and how the water nearby, especially the groundwater nearby, is recharged, and what is the method of evaluating this process also by intervention in the upper or the watershed area, and its impact over the groundwater recharge. So that will be also studied in detail here. And role of integrating forest trees, horticulture crops, field crops, grass and fodder. This we have already dealt in the agroforestry aspect, because where there is a scope of integrating the different components like forest trees, horticulture crops, agriculture crops, grasses and fodder trees. So that this aspect will be also studied in watershed management approach, how these can be integrated. Dear aspirants, that's all about forest soil, soil conservation and watershed management. I tried to give the very short note of this subject, and the detailed explanation will be followed in the coming session. And if you have any query, kindly let me know in the comment section below. And thanks for watching this video. Nandi Vanakkam. Silva, a ladder to reach Canada.